Let's begin with the top political story of the day. Bhabanipur and the battle for the seat is still rather ugly. We saw a lot of violence breaking out yesterday. It was the last day of campaigning. The BJP alleged that their leaders were attacked, were heckled by TMC goons. We've been seeing since then back and forth between the BJP and the TMC. The Election Commission has now stepped in, seeking a report on the alleged attack on BJP MP Dilip Ghosh. Here's a roundup of all the updates.
Guns, goons, and a fierce election battle. After the violent escalation in Bhabanipur, BJP has upped the ante against the TMC. The Saffron Party has approached the poll panel after former BJP Bengal chief Dilip Ghosh was heckled by a mob. On the last day of campaigning, tempers hit fever pitch, with Ghosh's guard being dragged by the collar, forcing the BJP vice president's security guard to point a gun at the crowd. Demanding that the by-poll be called off, the BJP delegation approached the poll panel with its demands.
And we more demanded the imposition of Section 144 in every single part of the constituency. It's a compact part of thing, and it can easily be done. Number two, we have demanded that the entire voting process must be captured on CCTV, webcast. The CAPF go not only engage in controlling things inside the booth, but outside the book, a process of area domination, instilling confidence, route marches.
The BJP has also demanded that the Kolkata police not to be allowed to manage security at polling booths. A fierce war of words has erupted with the TMC hitting back.
There was spontaneous protest against him. People shouted Joy Mal. Dilip Ghosh escaped. And his security guard pointed revolvers at the crowd. Ultimately, no harm was done to Dilip Ghosh because I saw pictures of him laughing and shouting Jai Sri Ram and going away from the place. All this was a drama to attract attention.
The Election Commission has now sought a status report on the ugly clash at Bhabanipur. With less than 24 hours to go before the votes are cast, the incident has heightened political temperatures in this high-stakes prestige battle. With Prema Rajaram in Kolkata, Bureau Report, India Today.
Let's take this across now to Prema Rajaram, who was on ground in Bhabanipur yesterday and witnessed all of the chaos and tension firsthand. Prema, good morning. The Election Commission has finally stepped in. You've got the BJP also putting forth a demand now that the by-poll be cancelled, that it not be held in a few days from now on September 30th. Is that likely to happen? What exactly is the poll panel saying as of now?
Well, there are two parts to this, Akshita. The first part is that the Election Commission has sought a report and to see what went wrong, why Dilip Ghosh was cornered and his security men had to pull out their pistols to keep the mob away. Secondly, the clashes between Trinamool Congress and BJP in Bhabanipur. And the second part is, of course, the fact that there is a PIL in the Calcutta High Court where today is a judgment and the Calcutta High Court will decide on whether the by-poll should take place, because there was a PIL citing that during the COVID-19 pandemic, there should not be any by-polls that take place. But of course, before that, what played out yesterday for that, BJP is saying that considering the law and order situation and that their leaders are not safe, when it comes to the people coming out to vote, they will be in fear and hence the by-polls should be cancelled. But in in a case that the bipoles are still held on the 30th of September, there should be proper security arrangements, CCTV cameras, like we heard Swapan Das Gupta saying, and also apart from that, Section 144 be imposed across Bhavanipur. It is a Trinamool Congress bastion because Trinamool Congress has won from there three times, and this time Mamata Banerjee is seeking to win from there. So the BJP not making a cakewalk for Mamata Banerjee and seeking Section 144 across Bhavanipur on the day of polling. Back to you, Akshita.
All right, Prema, for the moment, thank you very much for joining us. We'll continue tracking all the latest updates that come in on that story.